Christians in the Middle East are facing the harshest persecution in history. More than 100,000 from Syria and Iraq are refugees from the terrorist ISIS army. Survivors tell horrifying stories of beheading, rape, and forced conversion. As the Western world fails to take action against ISIS, many feel abandoned and alone. Now, a short film is calling the church to action. Sing a Little Louder is based on the true story of an old man who remembers the horrors of the Holocaust and the passivity of his family and his church in the face of evil. Take a look at this clip.
Years have passed and no one talks about it much anymore. I still hear that train whistle in my sleep. I can still hear him crying out for help. God forgive all of us who called ourselves Christians yet did nothing to intervene.
Joining us now from our Washington, D.C. bureau is Julia Tamirazi. She is founder and president of the Iraqi Christian Relief Council. The group is hosting a showing of the film in Washington. Juliana, this short film is very powerful. What do you hope to accomplish by showing it?
We want to wake the Christian world up. As we stand here and we say never again in terms of the Holocaust, there's a real genocide that is underway against the Christians throughout the Middle East, namely the Assyrian Christians in Iraq and Syria. And through this movie, we hope that we remind people, as they do not want another Holocaust on their hands, we let them know there is one underway.
Definitely. Describe briefly what's happening to Christians in the Middle East. Is it another Holocaust?
Absolutely. When people have been forcefully displaced from their homes, they're not able to work, they're being forced to convert, and they refuse to convert. These people rather die than convert to Islam. Therefore, they live in subhuman conditions. They're forced to live in storage bins without any windows, without any ventilation. They're not able to work. The kids are not being educated. Prior to 2003, there were 1.6 million Assyrian Christians in Iraq. Today, we have about 400,000 left there. And out of 400,000, 200,000 are displaced because of ISIS. 1.1 million have been displaced since 2003. All of this right in front of our eyes, and the Christian world is silent.
Why are Christians in the West so silent about what's happening?
Personally, I believe they do not want to become viewed. They do not want to be viewed as Islamophobes. They don't want to offend anybody. Even human rights organizations are not talking about it because they don't want to offend Muslims. And also, unfortunately, a lot of Christians that I meet on the road, they ask me, are these really real Christians? Have they been saved? And that's offensive to me as a cradle Christian. These people leave their homes and everything they've ever earned and worked for because they don't want to renounce Christ. These are our modern day martyrs. And we should not ask if they've been saved, if they're saved again, or born again, rather, if they're real Christians or not. The third is, if this is not happening to them, to their families, in their neighborhoods, and this is happening somewhere in a black hole called Iraq or Syria, then let somebody else take care of it. And this is why people turn a blind eye and a deaf ear.
Wow. Well, how should the church speak out? What action should it take?
First and foremost, we ought to kneel and pray. It is only through prayer that we can really make a difference. The Lord can save the situation. The second thing, very important, is to fund these people. These people that have been displaced, there's a child who is not being able to get educated because it's too expensive for him to go to school, and it only costs $8. There are cooling units that are in need. Food, the budget for food is running out starting July, and these people will go hungry if the church does not step up and help. The third is political involvement. 2016 is upon us, my friends, and we must, as one body of Christ, rise up and put pressure on the candidates for 2016 for them to put religious freedom and the cause of the Christians of the Middle East on their radar.
Indeed. What should our governments be doing to end the terror reign of ISIS?
You know, it is not only ISIS. Unfortunately, they are just a fraction of this whole ideological problem that we're faced with. We have Boko Haram, we have Muslim Brotherhood, we have Hamas and Hezbollah. So this is an ideology that we're fighting. That is correct. But we have to defeat ISIS for it not to expand this Islamic State called the Caliphate. We have to attack it with very strong airstrikes. We have to put some boots on the ground, but not only American boots. This has to be an all-encompassing coalition. We have to involve modern states, Islamic states like Jordan and Egypt, to get involved with this. This should not be a problem for America. This is a Judeo-Christian issue. That is one way, and the second way is educating. We have to educate our fellow Christians about the threat of the Islamic ideology.
Indeed. Tell us about the work of the Iraq Relief Fund and how it's helping persecuted Christians.
It's the Iraqi Christian Relief Council. We were founded in 2007. We travel throughout the country and we minister to churches about this plight. We really paint a human face on this situation. We raise money for food, shelter, medicine, clean water, and whatever else they need. We work with two main organizations on the ground, the Assyrian Aid Society that has been on the ground since 1991 in Iraq, and also the Dominican Sisters of St. Catherine of Siena. They've been there for a long time. They're displaced themselves. These are 32 nuns that are taking care of 60,000 people. That's in Iraq alone. This year, we've been graced to reach Jordan as well as Syria. So we help all Christians on the ground, regardless of their denomination. We even help Yazidis. Yazidis is another minority group in Iraq that has been completely devastated. So I invite you to visit our website at IraqiChristianRelief.org, IraqiChristianRelief.org, and also on Facebook and Twitter.
Juliana Tamorese, thank you so much for joining us today. God bless you.
Thank you. God bless you and all of your viewers. Thank you so much.